This short video explains how translocation, preimplantation, genetic diagnosis, or translocation PGD, can help translocation carriers have a successful pregnancy and a healthy baby. There are approximately 1 in 500 to 1 in 600 people in the population who are balanced translocation carriers, which is about 12 million people worldwide. Translocation carriers have an altered structure to their chromosomes, termed a balanced translocation, which exists in all the cells in their body. Translocation carriers typically show no physical symptoms until they try to have a baby, and it is then that they or their partner may experience difficulty achieving or in maintaining a pregnancy. Hence, translocation carriers have a higher risk of miscarriage. Chromosomes are found in the cells of our bodies. Each cell contains 23 pairs of chromosomes, and we inherit one of each pair from our mother and the other from our father. Chromosomes are made of DNA, which contains all the information necessary for life. Translocations can occur when DNA from one chromosome is swapped with the DNA of another chromosome. For example, here, the end of the blue chromosome has swapped over with the end of the pink chromosome. Overall, there is no net gain or loss of genetic material, and this is a balanced translocation. When eggs and sperm are formed, they must contain a single copy of every chromosome, so each of the 23 pairs separates. When eggs or sperm form from translocation carriers, they may result in the gains and losses of sections of chromosomes in the resulting sperm or egg, because the translocated chromosome has been separated from its balancing partner. As a result, there is too much of part of one chromosome and too little of part of another, and this is termed an unbalanced translocation. Embryos with unbalanced translocations are usually not viable. Illustrated in this diagram are just the two chromosomes involved in the translocation. The four most commonly seen outcomes or contributions from a balanced translocation carrier to an embryo are shown here. The egg or sperm could contain a normal complement of chromosomes with no translocations, or indeed a balanced complement of chromosomes, much like the parent translocation carrier. These egg or sperm would result in an embryo that would potentially be viable and could lead to a successful pregnancy. In these two scenarios, you can see that there is a gain of part of one chromosome and a loss of part of another. Egg or sperm with such a chromosome complement or unbalanced translocation would not usually make a viable embryo and are very likely to result in miscarriage. Couples that experience a high frequency of miscarriage may be referred for karyotyping, which is a classical technique used to determine the number and appearance of the chromosomes in an individual and can determine whether in fact you are a balanced translocation carrier. If it's been determined that you are a balanced translocation carrier, you may be advised to have IVF and translocation preimplantation genetic diagnosis, or PGD. Translocation PGD can screen all chromosomes and help select embryos for transfer that have no unbalanced translocations or any other whole chromosome gains or losses, and therefore reduce the chance of miscarriage and increase the likelihood of a healthy pregnancy. Translocation PGD can be performed at different developmental stages of the embryo. It can be performed on single cells taken from an embryo which has grown to 8 cells following fertilisation, termed a blastomere biopsy. Alternatively, it can be performed on a few cells, typically 5 to 10 cells, taken from the trophectoderm of a later stage embryo, or blastocyst, which has been grown to day 5. The cells of the trophectoderm essentially go on to form the placenta, so by removing a small number of cells causes no harm to the embryo. This type of biopsy is termed a trophectoderm biopsy. Translocation PGD screens all chromosomes during an IVF cycle to select only those embryos with no unbalanced translocations or any other chromosome gains or losses for transfer, thereby reducing the chance of miscarriage and increasing the likelihood of a healthy pregnancy. Translocation PGD using the comprehensive chromosome screening technique described here, where all chromosomes within the cell are screened, is offered by many of the leading IVF centres worldwide, and to date over 10,000 embryos have been screened, leading to many healthy pregnancies and many subsequent births.